Hey everyone, I'm Aliana and welcome to my channel. Recently, I finished the Google Data Analytics Professional Certificate courses in around 4 months, studying for about 30 minutes per day. This is a course review video for anyone who's interested in data analysis. I'll cover exactly what does the course offer and what to expect. The course link is in the video description. First of all, this is a course offered by Google on Coursera platform for people who are interested in becoming a data analyst. You don't really need any data analysis background to take the course. The price is $39 per month for the Coursera platform subscription. The course is self-paced. You can learn it at any time, and it has some short videos, readings, quizzes, activities, and a capstone project. I'd like to remind you that this is not just one course that you can finish in one sitting. Instead, it is a huge certificate, consists of 8 smaller certificate courses. It's like having 8 chapters of this big course. If you have previous experience of data analysis and you're only looking forward to improve one specific area, then you can take one smaller certificate course and you will still get a certificate, but it's just for that specific chapter you completed. It started with very intuitive and easy to understand content in the first few certificate courses, and then moved to something way more technical. These courses are structured to teach you the data analysis process. Ask, prepare, process, analyze, share, and act. In addition, you'll also learn the technical tools you needed to become a data analyst. And that includes spreadsheets, SQL, BigQuery, Kaggle, Tableau, and R programming language. The final certificate course is a capstone project in which you'll complete following a guidebook. And you can choose from 2 tracks. You can either work with existing question and data set, or you can follow your own case study plans. This capstone project helps you to build up a portfolio. Besides, the course also provides you some guidance on finding a job, such as how to write a resume, how to build portfolios on GitHub, Kaggle, Tableau, Medium, WordPress, or Google Slides, how to take interviews, and how to negotiate salary. Now let's talk about what I like about the course. The first thing being that it is short and to the point. I know it can take months to finish, but when it comes to the actual content and the individual videos, it's always a short video and there's no nonsense in the videos. Unlike, you know, listen to lectures for hours. The course is also extremely practical. No matter what concept it brings up, Google does a great job on connecting that concept to a practical real-world example. It always connects a technical problem to a real business problem. And that is something you might not get from other courses. Another thing I like about the course is that it is comprehensive and resourceful. It teaches you things like design thinking, visualization, and how to prepare a slideshow and present. These things are really, really important when it comes to actual work, but it can be something that we neglected while we are learning the hardcore skills. There are also many links you can refer to if you want to dig into a topic, and some cheat sheet you can download and use it anytime. Finally, I like it that Google did a good job on making technical content not so scary. This course did a great job on providing you just enough of the instruction you need to solve these problems, and it also helps you to find an online version of the tools you need just in case you don't want to go through all the hassles to download all these softwares. And when it comes to problem sets you just can't figure it out, it always provides you the right answer and the right code in a different file, so you can just see, oh, that's the right answer. Now let's talk about what I disliked. The first thing I dislike is the learning curve of the course. In the beginning, it's easy and intuitive, but suddenly it feels like it jumps into something very technical. This actually happens to every single Google course, and I think it's designed intentionally to help people get started. So it's good in a way, but bad in a way. And I'd like to remind you that just because you finish the first few certificate courses in a few hours, doesn't mean you can do the same for the rest of the courses. Another thing I didn't like about the course is the lack of peer-graded assignment. Unlike other courses that Google offers on Coursera, like the UX course and the project management course, those courses all have peer-graded assignments. So whenever you upload something, other people will grade it. However, for the activities in this course, no one will really grade your activities. So no one really knows how well did you do in these activities, or did you really do it or not. But I want to remind you that these activities are like the gold, because these activities are really well designed by Google, which have a lot of practical experiences and other courses may not offer. Finally, another thing that I think the course could improve upon is the capstone project. Now, I've done a capstone project for the UX course, the project management course, but for this course, it's just one PDF, pump, follow the instruction and complete everything. I'm a little bit used to other forms where I need to complete multiple activities and then combine them to one final project, but for this one, you really need to be self-motivated to complete the entire capstone project. And I highly recommend you to do so, because that's what will be going into your resume and your portfolio. Before I end this video, I'd like to offer you some study tips that I use. First, I think making a plan, either study plan or career plan, will be really helpful. And don't be too optimistic and don't be too rushed. Simply because this plan will help you to have an idea of why you're taking the course, why you should keep taking the course, and what you want to learn from the course, and what would you do after you finish the course. I also suggest you to find two accountability partners. This helps you to get into a competition environment where you guys are motivating each other to finish the course, but also collaborate in a way so that you guys can help each other out. There are so many contents and resources in this course, so I highly suggest you to find an organized way to take notes, and especially taking notes in a digital form, because there are spreadsheets, links, and code. You don't want to write code on pen and paper. Finally, and this is the most important thing I want to say to you, is try to adapt to a growth-oriented mindset instead of a goal-oriented mindset. Now, when we're doing these certificate courses, it's very easy to get into the track about thinking, when can I get that certificate? That certificate is a piece of paper, and just by putting that certificate into your resume really doesn't help you to find a job. Instead, what can really get you the job is the knowledge you acquired, the skills you acquired, and also the project you showcased in your portfolio. Finally, if you want to take the course, the link in the description. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my video, don't forget to subscribe. More content coming up soon. And if you have another course in mind that you want me to do a course review on, just comment. And I hope you enjoy learning and continue to learn different things. And I hope you have a great day. See you next time.